Hello there, welcome back to another video on 40.pound. My name is Steve and this is Phil alongside me, our resident kit expert. And if you don't know, we're reviewing all the kits for the 2019-20 season, including this absolutely stunning Liverpool goalkeeper kit. I never thought I'd be reviewing a goalkeeper kit, because who cares about them? But apparently this one is starting to fly off the pre-order shelves already. It's out 9th of May, and during our Liverpool home shirt review, which you can watch here, it'll be on the screen right about now, so go watch that after this video. Open it in a new tab, then come back to this. We talked about doing this, and this is the Liverpool home kit. Look at that, Phil. It should be your third shirt, shouldn't it? It should be. It's already away kit.
Exactly. A lot of people saying on Twitter, quite rightly, it would make a great away kit. And I think, as you say, the fact that we're even talking about it, even doing a video, says a lot. And I think in general, if we just think about goalkeepers in terms of where that position is going, in terms of players like Alisson and Ederson, it's obviously becoming more and more of a
rock and roll position now, isn't it?
I think it is, yeah. And I think it's great. I mean, we've always had goalkeeper kits, but I love the fact that we're getting a bit more attention.
Do you know what? I'm a 90s kid, so I remember when goalkeeper tops were absolutely crazy in the 90s. I think of Jorge Campos and people like that. Even Man City's kits in the 90s, goalkeeper kits, because I was a keeper as a kid. They were crazy and colourful and bold. In general, this isn't that, but it's definitely a lot more considered and focused. Even the fact that they put it in short sleeves shows to me that they knew it was good and they wanted to separate it as a shirt, if you know what I mean? Yeah. Because if it's in long sleeve, people just treat it like a goalkeeper top, even if it's nice. Mm-hmm. But the fact that it's in short sleeve, that looks very intentional to me. Do you know what I'm getting at with that?
Absolutely. And I think, you know, we've always seen, I think goalkeeper tops have primarily sort of been, they've played second fiddle. But the fact that this one, as you say, it's got available in long sleeve and short sleeve, I think just in terms of the design as well, it's nice to see, because we've seen quite a few black Liverpool goalkeeper tops, you know, famously, or infamously, Karius's kit when he did what he did was in black. But the fact that they've gone for the gold.
Yeah, the gold detailing.
It makes a big difference.
It's just, I'm not sure if it's as shiny as it looks in the photos, but it just really pops, doesn't it? It really does. It adds this kind of classiness to it.
And it's quite funny. In many ways, it shows up the home kit, because with the gold and the shininess of the gold, if you like, it makes the yellow of the details on the Liverpool kit just look a bit not as exciting. Now, obviously, the home kit, as we talked about in our video, was there for the retro reasons. But yeah, as a goalkeeper top, this is fantastic.
So has the reaction been this amongst the Liverpool community really strong then?
Really strong, I believe. And probably by the time this video goes out, it will be it's probably sold out, at least of the initial run for short sleeve. That's not to say there won't be more available. And I think in long sleeve, there might be some available. But yeah, absolutely. The other thing as well, which has really helped the release, is that Alisson has been announced as the new number one, so he's going to be wearing number one next year.
Why wasn't he number one?
Yeah, just because of Karius, I think, because by the time Karius had already been registered.
Everyone pretends he doesn't exist anymore.
Indeed, everyone sort of forgot he's at Beşiktaş in Turkey. So anyway.
It definitely helps that Alisson looks very cool there in that photo as well. He just got the right complexion, his beard's on point, he looks good. It's a very nice shirt, and we've been talking a lot on this channel in general about how the rise of football shirt culture is definitely a thing. Obviously, post the Nigeria shirt and post the great kits in the World Cup and all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. And it feels like New Balance are very much aware of this. Mm-hmm. And they obviously knew when they were creating this kit that they could be on something a bit special, a bit popular. Mm-hmm. Hence why they put it front and centre in some of these photo shoots, because it's a very good kit. Could we see more teams drawing this kind of, more kit manufacturers drawing this era of football shirts, really focuses on the goalkeeper shirt, because there's a lot of talk about fourth shirts in general, and that's just to sell, you know, like sell shirts essentially. Mm-hmm. But why don't they just focus on goalkeeper shirts instead? Mm-hmm. Because that could be the fourth shirt. You know, like instead of having to make another kit, they could just do better with the, you know, one that already is already there.
Yeah, and I think what you'll probably see is both. So I think you're absolutely right. Obviously, we're seeing more and more teams do special kits, fourth kits, and I think in tandem with that, you will also see more interesting goalkeeper kits. And and the few examples you can think of, there's been a few. On the sort of crazy side, I mean, I think we've talked before about Wycombe Wanderers are famous now for basically doing ridiculous goalkeeper tops every year. Very, very 90s kind of direction. And I think in general, it's one of those things where, obviously, as you say, you're going to make the kits anyway. And New Balance are sort of taking a leaf out of kind of Nike's book and the way they market it. Much more up front and centre. You know, it sounds obvious, but just really good marketing and photography goes a long way.
Of course it does,
You know, and a lot of brands, as you say, you will see nothing about the goalkeeper kit. Some of them, I think you can't even buy them in the stores.
I don't recall a single mention of cities last year, you know, like in general. It doesn't happen. You're right. And some of you rarely struggle to find them. True.
Yeah. And I think, obviously, we talk a lot about templates, and goalkeeper kits typically do suffer even more than you kind of home and away in terms of templates. Usually brands will roll out
a
template for their
2019
teams.
Goalkeepers are cool again, aren't they?
I think so.
You know what? They are. Like, you're seeing ball playing goalkeepers that confident, that composed. The part of the 11th, they never felt more involved, and maybe this is why. Honestly, it's probably a reaction to this. Keepers are marketable again. That's why David De Gea is a Finnish man. I'm not kidding. What do you guys go in the comments? But in general, I'm going to ask you to score this one as well. I know you've never scored a goalkeeper kit before, probably, but go for it.
Oh, no, this would be very strong. I think
87.
I was about to say 85. So, we're pretty much there.
Sorry,
I think that's the thing where, you know, this one, as you say, it would make a great awaken.
Is it, just playing devil's advocate, is it a bit too simple?
Well, I think that's the thing which, for me, this is sort of, I guess if you're going to do this really classy kind of direction with the black and gold, this is pretty much as good as it gets, but as you say, for it to be...
It's limited by its simplicity, almost.
Exactly. For it to be in the 90s, you really need something which is...
Memorable,
it needs to be the Campos type design, as ridiculous as that is. This is a superb shirt. You know, you should get this one if you
like
it.
Worth noting as well that the collars and both the home and the goalkeeper shirt are nice. I like simple collars personally. That's just a personal thing. Anyway, let us know what you make of that goalkeeper shirt. Don't forget to check out the home shirt review as well. We're going to be reviewing all the shirts for next season on 40.com. So make sure you subscribe to our channel if you're a big fan of football shirt culture. Anyway, my name is Stephen. This is Phil. See you in a bit.